Well, the day is finally here. Intel is officially launching the Core i9-7980 Extreme Edition and the Core i9-7960X. Both of these are the new Halo products for Intel in their high-end desktop lineup, which means they are supposed to compete with AMD's Ryzen Threadripper CPUs. Now, both these CPUs cost around $3,700. Actually, come to think of it, I shouldn't be holding them like this. So let me place them safely and let's get to the B-roll. These Skylake processors haven't really been a mystery at all, since we've known about their pricing and core counts since this year's Computex. Back then, Intel launched the i9-7900X, the i9-7820X, and the i9-7800K, along with the Kaby Lake X processors, which seem ridiculous, which we're not going to get into that anyways, and of course their new X299 platform. But at the same time, they knew AMD had Threadripper waiting in the wings, and those 12 or 16 core processors would actually beat the higher-end Skylake X processors on the market. So what did Intel do? Well, they announced the core counts and pricing for the i9-7980XE and the i9-7960X in an attempt to take some of the wind out of Threadripper's sails. But did that strategy really work? I mean, it's debatable since AMD just quickly launched the $1,000 1950X and the $800 1920X, both of which cost less than what Intel's offering and should offer competitive performance. If you're interested in review for those two new CPUs, you can check them out right here. Now, Intel's officially hit back with this launch, and looking at the specs of these two new CPUs, I'm thoroughly impressed. Let's actually start with this guy, the 18-core 36-threaded monster, the i9-7980 Extreme Edition. But first, a quick message from our sponsor.
The NZXT Hue Plus lighting control hub is now available in the white frame to complement the white NZXT Manta case or other white theme builds for best hardware color coordination with enough extensions included, and is used to control the four very bright RGB LED strips or the Air RGB fans, all through the Hue Plus hub. Check it out in the description below.
Okay, so the first thing you'll see is that pricing of $2,000, but since we've already known that for months now, I'm guessing the sticker shock will be a bit less. Not gone, just less, because this one processor costs as much as a high-end gaming PC. However, its core clock speeds are actually pretty decent. Of course, due to the massive amount of heat being generated with that 165-watt TDP and the input power it requires, Intel had to keep the 7980XE's base clock to a pretty low 2.6 GHz, but in testing, I never saw the chip run under 3.5 GHz. However, as less cores are utilized, Intel's Turbo Boost technology really takes over and runs up speeds even higher. It maxes out between 4.2 GHz and 4.4 GHz, which will be very important for games which typically don't load a processor all that much. The $1,700 i9-7960X has very similar clock speeds and specs as its bigger brother, but it has 16 cores and 32 threads, along with a price that's a bit less expensive. It will still put a very big hole in your pocket though. Now, while the i9-7980 Extreme Edition doesn't really have a direct competitor from AMD just yet, the 7960X has the exact same number of cores and threads as the 1950X, and yet it costs $700 more. Really, Intel? Actually, let me put some of this pricing into perspective for you guys. You can effectively buy a Threadripper 1950X, an ASUS Prime X399A motherboard, and a GTX 1080 for the price of a single i9-7980 Extreme Edition, or grab a 1950X and a GTX 1080 without going over the 7960X's price point. Intel's also launching the i9-7940X and the i9-7920X today as well, but since this video will focus on higher-end CPUs, I'll just let you pause the screen on this chart to check out the specs. Something else you should take into account is the amount of heat these processors generate and the power they consume. I'll get into the specifics a bit later in this review, but if you're about to buy one of these new processors, a high-end air cooler or a very good single-bar all-in-one liquid cooler is absolutely necessary. Another thing that will always come up in a Threadripper versus Skylake X debate will be the number of PCI lanes offered by the processors. Basically, allowing the processor to communicate directly with an attached device should, in theory, lower latencies and boost overall performance. So the more the CPU has, the better. Threadripper processors have a total of 48 3.0 lanes available for graphics and another dozen set for high-speed NVMe storage solutions. Meanwhile, Intel has 44 lanes available, which are typically split with 40 being dedicated towards graphic solutions, while another 4 can be towards NVMe or other types of high bandwidth storage. The balance of PCI ports are housed on the X299 PCH. I'll be testing to see if there's any difference between the two solutions, but on paper, AMD's setup is superior since it cuts out the chipset and allows for a more direct communication with the key components. Before I get into the benchmarks, there's something I have to remind you as well. It is important to approach this review from the perspective of a technology lover rather than an outright critic. Like Threadripper, the high-end Skylake X processors are technological marvels which will command respect while also attracting endless flame wars. But neither Intel nor AMD are targeting their $1,000 plus processors at gamers who can buy a complete mid to high-end gaming system for the cost of a single 16 or 18 core CPU. You need to have a very specific set of needs to benefit from the gobs of horsepower these things bring to the table. Even then, without properly setting native core affinity for programs, a lot of that potential will go to waste. Just make sure you remember that before criticizing or praising down in the comments down below. So with that in mind, let's get into the benchmarks. Okay, first up, here's a quick glance at the testing setup that we used for each system. We tried to keep everything as identical as possible from one another. Starting off with Cinebench's multi-threaded results, it is obvious that the Extreme Edition processor is the processor to beat right now. The 7960X isn't that far behind and both easily beat the Threadripper processors. The same can be said about W Prime results. Next up is PCMark, and it's obvious that the home and creative benchmarks likely reflect what to expect from these processors in the real world. Since this test combines multiple different workloads, the massive number of cores doesn't benefit in every scenario. I wanted to test out some single core benchmarks too, and here they are. With Turbo Boost 3.0 working in the background, the 7980XE and the 7960X remain very far ahead of AMD's Threadripper, but there are still some Kaby Lake and Kaby Lake X processors ahead of them. All right, so I guess that's it for synthetic benchmarks since I want most of this review to focus on real-world performance. And for that, let's start off with Adobe Premiere. So this is an interesting result and one that I have to explain since neither the Skylake X or Threadripper processors do as well as you might expect. While the 18 and 16 core Intel parts are still leading Threadripper, Adobe Premiere requires a balance of higher clock speeds and threads to perform optimally. Anything over 12 threads results in diminishing returns unless you overclock. In 7-Zip, the Extreme Edition processor and the 7960X really fly ahead since this is a program that makes use of Intel's recent optimizations and it loves additional cores. Blender is the same thing as well, with Intel taking a massive lead over AMD. It is important to highlight that the $300 premium for the Extreme Edition processor isn't really beneficial here since the 7960X is able to hit higher clock speeds more frequently. The results repeat themselves in Corona. It's interesting to see that while Skylake X was ahead in the synthetic benchmarks, the lead over Threadripper is actually increasing in real-world testing. And that's interesting. Since GIMP is a very lightly threaded program, you are better off going with a much less expensive but faster clock processor if you can use it on a regular basis. Moving back to a more multi-threaded program shows these new Intel chips in the lead again, but not by all that much over Threadripper. It seems like something else might be causing a bottleneck in the systems other than the processor. POV rate actually raises a good question. Are the 7980XE and the 7960X really worth all that much money over Threadripper's 1950X? Sure, they have a lead, but it isn't a lead that's worth $900 and $600 more. Rounding up the real-world benchmarks in WinRAR, and interestingly, the i9-7900K has a huge lead over everything. This is because WinRAR doesn't stress all cores, and that one processor was able to achieve a much higher average clock speed during the test. Okay guys, I know that I said these processors aren't meant for gaming since there are much better values in this market if you just want to have a good time. But none of our reviews would be complete without a little gameplay. Obviously, the Firestrike Benchmarks loves the number of threads offered by the Extreme Edition processor and the 7960X. Their lead is absolutely massive, but TimeSpy is a little bit different since the graphics card dictates more of the score, so all of the CPUs score very close to one another. Moving through all the other games, you can actually see that there's really no need for such expensive processors if gaming is your system's primary use. In some cases, even our ultra-powerful Titan X became the bottleneck, while in others, the game developers themselves have capped frame rates to try and improve the overall experience. Sure, there are titles that do benefit from the extra cores, and Intel's Skylake X is always ahead of Threadripper in the results, but not by all that much. honestly, guys, you'd be much better off spending money on a better graphics card than jumping from a Ryzen or Kaby Lake processor to Threadripper or Skylake X. So now with performance out of the way, I think it's time to talk about temperatures and power consumption, since they are two areas that will play a key factor in the Skylake X story. When loading up the systems, both the i9-7980 Extreme Edition and the i9-7960X became the most power-hungry processors I've ever tested in the last 2 years. By a long shot, too. They both require significantly more input power than AMD's Threadripper and suck down in excess of 50 watts more than the i9-7900X. It looks like Intel tried to push Skylake X's frequencies as high as possible in order to beat Threadripper, and the end result is excess power consumption. With that amount of power consumption, as you would imagine, the amount of heat being generated is on the next level. You will absolutely need a high-end air cooler or a very good all-in-one liquid cooler, at least as a minimum. Even with a Noctua NHU14S, the i9-79 Extreme Edition processor topped out at 77 degrees Celsius, which is the highest I've ever seen a stock processor hit on this cooler. It isn't anywhere close to throttling, but still, this is something you will want to take into account when buying one of these new CPUs. With those results taken into account, I think this is a great time to talk about overclocking as well, and for that, you will need to spend some pretty special equipment. A dual or triple fan all-in-one liquid cooler will be must, or if you're going with an air cooling solution, something like the Noctua NHU14S with two fans installed would be a minimum. On the power supply side, you will need at least a unit that has dual 8-pin CPU connectors. According to our motherboard partners, these new processors can draw well over 400 watts from the 12-volt rail when overclocked over 4 gigahertz on all cores. This also means that motherboard vendors will have a challenge with VRMs on some motherboards. As a matter of fact, Gigabyte recommended buying their new Aorus X299 Pro series if you plan on overclocking any 16 or 18 core Skylake X processors. Those motherboards have a different power layout and feature active cooling over their MOSFETs. I didn't have much time to overclock these processors, so I focused on the i9-7960X. With good cooling, I was able to hit a constant 3.9 GHz on all 16 cores, and I'm sure I could have gone a bit further with more time. But even then, I saw scores that easily matched or exceeded the Extreme Edition processor. Unfortunately, hitting this speed also meant my system needed almost 100 watts more power from the wall.
Always stay charged with Linky PowerUp power banks, housed in gorgeous aluminum enclosure with dual USB and Type-C port with support for Quick Charge 3.0 to get your devices recharged fast. Available up to 20,100 mAh capacities, check them out in the description below.
And that's a wrap up for Skylake X, guys. And let me tell you, this one's gonna be a hard one to wrap up. First up, I have to give mad props to Intel for pushing the boundaries in the high-end desktop market. The i9-7960X and the i9-7980 Extreme Edition CPUs are the fastest processors you can buy right now, period. They're fast, they're dynamic, they're adaptable, and most importantly, they can blaze through any applications imaginable. As you can tell, I'm pretty excited to have these two new CPUs here in the studio. But I also have to remember that Intel sent over $3,700 worth of CPUs to us, while you guys have to be spending the real money on them. And let's be honest here, Skylake X demands a ton of money. In most usage cases, spending that extra money wouldn't be worth the while over Threadripper, since an average of 15% better performance over a 100% price premium just doesn't make any sense. But a 10 to 20% reduction in rendering times over Threadripper could mean real money savings for professionals, and for them, spending the extra $600 or $1,000 for the 7960X or the 7980 Extreme Edition could be money well spent. But gamers, don't think about spending that extra money on these two new CPUs, because you're much better off with a CPU that costs one third of the price. So the 7960X or the 7980 Extreme Edition are crazy expensive, and in most situations, others less cost alternatives will be the better choice. But if you're someone who absolutely needs the best multi-threaded performance that money can buy on the desktop platform, then maybe, just maybe, Skylake X will be a good fit. So what do you guys think of these two new CPUs from Intel? Professionals, do you see yourself spending that extra cash to save that rendering times? And of course, gamers, do you see yourself benefiting from the CPU while you can do gaming and of course streaming in parallel? Or are you much better off with Threadripper? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm Ivor with HardwareCanucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe for more similar content, and we'll see you in the next one.